So hey guys, welcome back. We are doing the chapter Assets, Basis and Solution. And in this chapter, we were doing the question answers, right? So how many question answers we have done up till now? Only one session we have taken. Okay, and there are five question answers we have done. I think you all are doing well with these question answers and you are thorough with the all question answers which we are doing. At least five we have done, right? And the syllabus, I have, that is the theory part, I have already completed, and I hope you are doing, you're trying to fetch new questions and ask whenever you feel like, okay? Whenever you have a doubt, you can ask the questions. So let's just quickly move to the today's session. So the first question of the day is, the two solutions A and B have pH of 3 and 5 respectively. Which of the two solution has more hydrogen ion concentration and which one is more acidic? Give reason for your answer. Okay. So, see, I'll make you understand it so that you can write it on your own also. Okay. So, from now, I'll try to give you just explanation. Okay. So, how you will be able to understand? See, we have given two solution, that is A and B. They have said ki A is having pH of 3 and B is having pH of 5. So there are two pH given. So I have already explained you about this in the last session that if there is, this is a pH scale, okay? This is a pH scale, it will always run from 0 to 14. This is your 7, which is neutral, okay? And it is always going to show the concentration of H plus equal to concentration of OH minus. Okay? So this is what I have explained you. So also remember ki whenever there is increase, see in this side it is basic, and always remember here OH minus ion concentration is increasing. Okay? Whereas this is your acidic, and your acidic means there is increase in H plus ion concentration. So more you go towards the left, okay, more you go towards this side, the acidity of the solution increases. And when acidity of solution increases, it simply indicates that there is increase in hydrogen ion. So 3 is near to 0. It represents more hydrogen ion concentration. Okay? Right, so these acids are more acidic, whereas this will be less acidic as compared to A. So you can write, I have given you the reason and explanation also. So you can write the answer accordingly, that solution A with pH of 3 will contain more hydrogen ion concentration as it shows the more acidic behavior of the solution. Hence, we can say that the pH near to 0 is always going to show high H plus ion concentration, showing strong acidic solution. Clear? Okay. Moving to the next question. That is question number 2. Explain why an aqueous solution of sodium sulfate is neutral while an aqueous solution of sodium carbonate is basic in nature. So for understanding this question, you need to remember or you need to understand this particular example, that is the reaction. This is your sodium sulfate. Okay? They have said aqueous, that means there is presence of water. Okay? So this sodium sulfate, when it is reacting with water, whenever it is forming a solution with water, that means it is going to react with water. So when there is a reaction between sodium sulfate and water, there will be production of a strong base which is known as caustic soda or sodium hydroxide is formed, along with the production of a very strong acid, that is H2SO4. When there is both, that is the base and the acid which is coming out of this reaction, are strong. We have studied in our session, that is strong base and strong acid ka salt is always going to be neutral. ठीक है, because this will lead, because this is going to make, why neutral? Because this is going to make the concentration of H plus ion equal to concentration of OH minus ions, right? So that is why it is always going to be neutral. Clear? Now when we say what sodium carbonate, ठीक है, so sodium carbonate is Na2CO3, right? So Na2CO3 is when dissolved in water, it is always going to form, see, it is the basic in nature, right? It is basic in nature. Why it is so? Because this Na2CO3 on dissolution with water, it is going to release a strong base, which is NaOH, okay? This strong base, which is known as sodium hydroxide or alkali, is released along with a weak acid, which is CH2CO3. So when there is a strong base and weak acid ka salt, it is always going to form a basic salt. Take care, basic salt or basic solution. So that is why we can say that the solution of sodium sulfate is going to be always neutral, whereas solution of sodium carbonate is basic, because it contains, when it is dissolved in water, it gets ionized, it gets converted to strong base, that is NaOH, and a weak acid which hardly ionized, which partially ionized, releasing only H plus ion, okay, a single H plus ion, whereas it will be ionized to OH minus, to OH minus ion. So definitely there will be more concentration of OH minus ion in this solution. That is why this is always going to be basic in nature. So you have to write the equation and explain accordingly. Is this clear? Chal, moving to question number 3. What is the gas, or say name the gas which is usually produced when dilute sulfuric acid reacts with a metal? Illustrate it with an example. How will you test the evolution of gas? Okay, so first thing, for this I'll just give you the common understanding of it. That is, when you say dilute sulfuric acid, this is your H2SO4. Okay, this is your dilute sulfuric acid. When it is reacted with a metal, say zinc, for example, zinc. So whenever it is going to react with a metal, it is going to release a salt and hydrogen gas. Okay? So it's a balanced equation, you can see. So whenever a hydrogen gas is released, okay? So with release of hydrogen gas, how will you come to know that there is a release of hydrogen gas? So simple thing, there will be bubbles formed. But this gas can be tested only. Suppose kar lo ki ye ek test tube hai. Is test tube mein there is H2SO4 and zinc granules added. So when zinc granules added, they will give this reaction. And due to this reaction, there will be bubble ka formation and slowly the gas will come out. So do one thing, burn a matchstick, okay? Ek matches ko jalao. So you burn a matchstick. When matchstick is burnt, this gas is also going to come up and it will burn, this gas will burn with a popping sound, indicating the production of hydrogen gas. So whenever there is a hydrogen gas production, you can simply test it by this simple method, that is, bring a burning matchstick near the mouth of the test tube. Okay, so you will write in the format. Okay, so this one you can write, that is, there is hydrogen gas produced with the help of reaction, right? And you will write for the second question, that is, how will you test? You will write, bring the burning matchstick match stick near the mouth of test tube of reaction, ठीक है, जिसमें रिएक्शन हो रहा है, ठीक है. सो यू कैन सिंपली आइडेंटिफाई कि when की जो है, एंड इफ द गैस ऑल्सो बर्न्स विथ पॉपिंग साउंड it will be H2 gas. So this is the test you can write in this question. Sure. Then let's move to the next question, that is question number 4. Write a chemical equation to describe how baking soda is produced on a large scale. So for baking soda ke liye what we do, we simply use the brine solution. Okay. What is a brine solution? This is known as brine solution. Okay, this is your brine solution. When you bubble ammonia into it, it becomes ammoniacal brine. Okay, this is your ammoniacal brine. And when you add or pass carbon dioxide through it will form NaHCO3 plus NH4Cl. So this NaHCO3 is nothing but your baking soda. Clear? So you can write the equation, and then to the chemicals you can write the name of the chemicals as this one is your sodium hydrogen carbonate, and this is your ammonium chloride. Here, so these are the products and how the reaction is occurring, I have explained. Clear? Now you can write it in your simple words that whenever ammonia is bubbled to brine solution, the solution turns to ammoniacal brine. To this ammoniacal brine, we can pass carbon dioxide, which will lead to the formation of baking soda and ammonium chloride. Baking soda is nothing but sodium hydrogen carbonate. Write this equation, your answer will be complete. Here, moving to the fifth and the last question of the session, that is, it is converted into three parts. Okay, so write the name given to bases that are highly soluble in water. Okay, so you have to give the name to the bases that are highly soluble in water. So you will write, firstly you will write the answer. This is very simple, you have to remember. The bases that are highly soluble in water are called as alkalis. ठीक है, फाइन. फर्स्ट तो आंसर हो गया, मतलब किसका, ए का. ठीक है, अल्कली. एग्जाम्पल NaOH, MgOH twice. सो दीज आर दी अल्कलीज. ठीक है, सो दीज आर अल्कलीज, यू कैन सी. Now, the next one, how is tooth decay related to pH? So, when you say tooth decay, na, so tooth decay is basically occurring due to the lowering of pH. So whenever you will find that there is a mouth ka jo pH hai, if the pH of mouth goes below 5.5, there will be decay of tooth. 5.5 se kam ho gaya agar to pH, theek hai, to aapka tooth decay will occur. So this will be leading to tooth decay. So how the pH of mouth goes below 5.5? Basically it is because when you eat food and that food is stuck between your mouth, between the teeth of teeth, so it will be partially digested forming acid. When there is an acid production, there will be lowering of pH in mouth and hence your tooth will decay. Okay, so that so you remember this, whenever there is a pH of less than 5.5 in mouth, there will be a decay of tooth. Okay, then third one, why does bee sting cause pain and irritation? Rubbing of baking soda on the sting area gives relief. How? So basically the sting of bee contains organic acid in it, and this acid leads to the irritation and pain. So you will write the sting of bee contains acid, or you can say sting of bee contains organic acid, which basically cause pain and irritation. And when we rub it with baking soda, this acid, baking soda is basic in nature, no? So this baking soda is going to neutralize, okay? I'll write here, baking soda will neutralize the acid. Baking soda will neutralize the acid forming salt, okay? So there will be neutralization of acid, okay? And due to which you will feel relief from the stung of the, wherever the area of sting is there, that will be relieved by the neutralization reaction. Now, with this, the session is finished. So we'll end up the session over here. So I hope all the questions are clear to you. And once there is a doubt, any doubt you are having, okay, you can just ask me. And I'll help you with the same. Again, in every session I say this, because I know you people don't ask easily. So once you start studying, you'll get a lot of doubts. Please start studying if you have not started yet, and ask me the doubts. So with this, I'll end up the session. We'll meet in the next session. Till then, bye bye.